ओम नमः शिवाय स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ऑनलाइन क्लास ऑफ क्लास 11 मास मीडिया स्टडीज़। स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव स्टार्टेड ऑफ विद यूनिट 2 एवोल्यूशन ऑफ मीडिया चैप्टर 1 अंडरस्टैंडिंग सिनेमा पार्ट 1। नाउ टुडे इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डू द लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ द फर्स्ट चैप्टर, दैट इज थिएटर एंड सिनेमा। नाउ स्टूडेंट्स, लेट मी टेल यू दैट थिएटर एंड सिनेमा आर टू डिफरेंट आर्ट mediums that incorporate some similar aspects such as acting and theatrics. Now this is the basic common thing between theater and cinema, but we should remember that they have many major differences as well. The most major difference is that theater occurs live in front of an audience, whereas cinema is recorded and two-dimensional. With a pre-recorded medium, the audience can expect the same piece of art over and over. That means the quality of art being produced by cinema remains same through the length of time, through the whole length of time, whereas the art that is being produced by theater changes with each time because that is a live show, whereas the cinema is a recorded and then it is displayed. Okay, that means theater, the live art, can differ each time. Okay, now one more thing, that theater is limited to what can be portrayed on a stage, whereas cinema has a vast reach. It can incorporate many a things. Now, the most effective definition of theater, as told by Peter Brook in his book The Empty Space, defines that I can take any empty space and call it a bare stage. A man walks across this space whilst someone else is watching him, and this is all that is needed an actor of theater to be engaged. So this is a very definition. That means whenever you are given an empty space, and even if a man is walking through it, so that is something being enacted, you can say that, isn't it? So that is the basic thing that is needed to make a theater. Now, much more props and cons are there, much more setting are there, setups are there, costumes are there, makeup are there, lights are there. All these things are the secondary thing, but the primary thing is that a stage and actors. That is the basic requirement for your theater. Whereas in cinema, if you see, only the actors and the stage and the setting is not enough. You, because it is to be recorded, so many things, other things are also needed. So that is the most basic thing. That is the most basic difference between cinema and theater. Got it? So students, what we can see, that like cinema, theater is also an audio visual and spatio-temporal activities, and it has actors, scene changes, lighting, costume, makeup, set, story, etc. But these are only the limitations, the very few things. Mostly these are the superficial similarity, and if in deep we go, we will see there is a lot more difference between theater and cinema. The way of presentation differs. Now, what are the basic difference that happens in a cinema? It can be in term of venue, it can be in term of presentation, it can be in term of creative process, and it can be in term of origins also. Now, if we talk about venue, what happens, you know, that theater has stage venues such as in a playhouse, whereas films are played anywhere with a screen or projector. That means to see a theater, you need a particular place, whereas to see a cinema, no particular place is required. Now, theater holds a deeper connection between the audience and actors because the audience is seeing the character's story happening right in front of them, isn't it? As if they are peeking into the actual life of a stranger. They're getting to see in front of them. It is happening, no. But what happens in cinema? Cinema is limited to a two-dimensional screen and has more distraction from the actual characters through things like different camera angles, special effects, or scenery shots. No, isn't happening, no. That at time it is happening that you are acting, you are seeing the image of the you are seeing the image of the same actor at a time reflected from different angles. It happens in cinema, but that is not possible in theater. So how that is possible in cinema? It is only because of the editing. It is because of the editing you can see that. So that causes distraction from the acting of the main actor. But in theater, what happens? Your focus remains engaged to the actor's acting only. Am I clear, students? Next comes the presentation. The presentation itself is very different between the two, that means between theater and cinema. Now, theater occurs live in front of an audience, whereas cinema is recorded and two-dimensional. Now, then with a pre-recorded, the audience is expecting, as I told you, the same piece of art over and over. But whereas in cinema, it cannot, because it is live, and live art can differ each time. Isn't it? Live art can each... Now, for example, if you watch any live show of any singer, that you're one of your favorites also, it can be. If you compare each of the shows of the same artist, you will definitely note some differences. But if you listen to the same song the same song of that same artist over some channel or some recorded one, that in fact, if that song is there in some movie or cinema, you will never find any difference. It will always remains the same. So that also happens in theater and cinema. Got it? Okay. Next comes the creative process. It's very important to know that what happens in cinema, that we are only seeing the actors on the screen. We are not at all seeing the other people's responsible or required to make that film. To make that film, isn't it? For example, the hairdresser, for example, the cameraman, for example, the makeup artist. All these people are also as not... if not as important as the actors, but also important, isn't it? So there is a gap between the on-screen and the off-screen. There is a gap between the on-screen and off-screen. We are always crazy about on-screen. We are never so much bothered about what is happening off-screen. But in theater, this opposite happens. Everyone is working in a team. We are getting to get in contact with both the persons. That means whoever is arranging the light, whoever is arranging the music, whoever is raising the curtain, whoever is prompting the dialogues, all those things. Okay, all those things happens in an open stage, in an open stage in theater. So that is the basic difference between creating process. That is the basic difference of creating cinema and creating theater. Clear? Okay. Now, the origins, the one most important thing. What happens? The origins of each medium, that means both the cinema and theater, are very different. And the lengths of time they have existed are also very different. Now, if you talk about theater can be traced back to ancient Grecian times, that means very early times, and began as a religious medium. This Grecian time is one of the calculations of a calendar. Now, religious medium, that means one of the, at one time when the, that some life stories of the gods and goddesses were being enacted for the entertainment purposes. That was the medium. In Bengali, we can say that, it is commonly called as Jatra also. Okay, now, cinema originated amidst technological advances in the early 1900s, when pictures were captured on cameras and then turned into films. Now, how we can see the slideshows are happening, in that way cinema first originated. Now, cinema has been so rapid growth, that means technological advancement has moved it far away from where it originated from. But theater is still evolving or revolving around its originality only. Got it? So these are the basic differences between cinema and your theater. Now, over here also we have few differences. You should read all those things. Let's have a look. That while watching a play, point of view of the spectator is fixed depending upon where he is sitting in the auditorium. Now, while watching a film, point of view of the spectator is constantly changing due to the editing and camera movements. No editing is there in theater, whereas in cinema there is lots of editing. Each spectator has a different point of view of looking at the stage play, and each spectator has the same point of view as the other at all times. Technology can be useful but not necessary for the production of a play. Now, technology is absolutely essential. Without technology, no cinema can be produced. Theatre is live communication. Cinema is absolutely recorded audio-visual images. Isn't it? Now, the quality of the performance varies each time. Quality of the performance is fixed once and for all. It doesn't change. In theatre, we see actors in life-size reality. In cinema, the actors are always larger than life images. An actor's presence is the defining feature of the art of theatre. The process of editing, which brings together various elements, gives cinema its own identity. So, these are the basic difference. These are the difference, how we can make a differentiation between theatre and cinema. Now, how we can define now the cinema? That initially we have learned that simple definition of cinema, that cinema is an audio-visual spatio-temporal art. Now we are getting more refined definition that cinema is a temporal art that creates an illusion of a complete three-dimensional world through the projection of a two-dimensional image and recorded sounds. So it's a recorded one, and it's a temporal art, and that is creating an illusion of a complete three-dimensional world. Illusion, in fact, in front of us, it is an illusion being created. Clear, students? Now, over here, we have a very nice activity. Got it? Over here, you are given Anton Chekhov, a very famous Russian writer. Anton Chekhov's play, that is the anniversary. Okay, and this is your activity. That means you have to go through the entire play and then you have to enact. That thing we will do afterwards when we meet. Now, for the time being, you will go through the entire play. Now, before that, I will give you a briefing of the play. Clear? Now, over here, you will see that The Anniversary by Anton Chekhov is a hilarious play. That means very comical. About a banker who is preparing to meet some respected shareholders for the bank's 15th anniversary celebrations. Now, the play revolves around four principal characters. Okay, first one is Andrei Andreevich Sipuchin. He is the chairman of the Ain Joint Stock Bank, a middle-aged man with a monocle. Clear? Now, one more point to say that he has a soft corner for women, which is making it more comical, as we will explore. Next is Tanshanal Eximina, his wife, who is aged 25. Next, Kuzma Nikolovich Kirin, the bank's aged bookkeeper. And next is Natasha Fedorova Marchunkina, an old woman wearing an old-fashioned cloak. Other than that, we have the directors of the bank and employees of the bank. Now, if we talk about the setting, the action takes place at the bank. That's why we can say that it is a one-act play. It is a one-act play. That means the play that is being played at one go. Now, since it is a bank, we have the money also, and money employed in the play with English equivalents. All those things are over there. Now, over here, it is starting the anniversary. Now, I will give you the storyline. I will tell you the storyline in brief. Okay, of the play, I will tell you the storyline in brief. So, what happens in the story is that the story begins with the accountant busy preparing the financial report using the abacus. He is already worn out due to days of continuous work. That means he is exhausted. He tries to put long hours since the banker has promised him a golden watch if the meeting with the shareholders go well. So, while the accountant is busy with the calculations, the banker walks in along with his customers who wish him good luck for the meeting. The accountant, who has been watching all these, is not convinced at all. The fact that the banker will corner all the glory of his account's hard work does not go down well with him. However, he continues his work for the watch. So that means that person, the calculation, the accountant is very much engrossed in his work. He want the watch. Now, on the other hand, Mrs. Tanshiana comes to the bank as she has just arrived from her hometown after meeting her sister and mother. Clear? Instead of going home, she has arrived at her husband's bank. Her husband is very surprised by her visit and spends time with her on a casual talk so as to make her feel good. But he is worried if he was preparing enough for the meeting later in the day, whether he is being prepared because he was spending time. No. Tanshiana completely kept chattering about her train journey and her sister's date. However, at the end of the room, the accountant was growing very impatient and Mrs. Tanshiana's irrelevant narrations were getting on to his nerves, preventing him from focusing on the abacus. So Tanshiana was actually talking nothing. She was talking just as usual, nothing so important. In the midst of all of this happening, suddenly what happened? An old woman barged into the bank. That means came suddenly, you know. She seemed highly agitated and rushed to Mr. Banker's seat. She immediately went over there. The banker wondered if this was an aggrieved customer, only to realize later that she was Mrs. Marchutkina, who had come in to ruin his day. Now, she wanted the bank to pay her husband's complete wage of 24 rubles and 36 kopecks, which she claimed had been wrongly deducted. However, her husband never worked with the bank and the bank never had anything to do with the payment of his wages. Now the banker tried in vain to explain her, but she simply does not comprehend his logic. She was not at the point of understanding. Instead, she continues to demand her 24 rubles and 36 kopecks and that she is a weak and defenseless woman. Clear? Now, by the time, the banker is also helped by his wife, who demands Mrs. Marchutkina to leave the bank immediately. But the woman was very much stubborn. He refuses and is persistent on her demands. Finally, at the end of its wits, the accountant, who has been silent victim all this while, threatens to get her down out of the bank if she did not leave by herself. Even this threat did not deter her from demanding her husband's rightful share of wages. Now, realizing that there was no way out, the banker finally hands over 24 rubles and 36 kopecks to her, which she gleefully accepts, and momentarily there is a pause in the commotion. That means whatever the chaos and commotion was taking place. Meanwhile, Tanshiana continues her story to the banker, who by now is already drained of his energies. Mrs. Marchutkina had already drained of him. No. Just when things were beginning to return to peace again, that woman reaches out to the banker and asks, "Could my husband have his job back, Your Excellency?" This was height, no? This banker, upon reaching the end of his patience, order the accountant to throw her out from the bank. But the accountant mistakes Tanshiana to be the cause of the banker's anger and orders her out instead. How? Think. Just think, student. In the ensuing confusion, the accountant ends up chasing the mad woman and Tanshiana around the bank when the group of shareholders walk in. So there was complete commotion. Amidst all this commotion, the shareholders are unmoved and heap praise on Mr. Banker on how he had raised the bank to high reputation. Definitely, if Mr. Banker had to deal with such commotion, such chaotic situation. However, they stopped their praise midway and announced that they would come back some other day, considering that there was hectic activity at the bank at present. So what happens at the end? That meeting which he was planning in the morning, ultimately did not end at a peace note, at a happy note. It was again at a stick. So this is what the storyline is saying to you. Clear? Now you will read the entire play And when we will meet, as I said, we will do the enactment. With this, we are complete. We are done with the first chapter of Unit 2. So we are ending our class here. Thank you. Om Namah Shivaya.